everyone. Very good afternoon. Welcome for the session. I really appreciate students who have logged on time. Good to see you, Abhirami, on time. Hi, NH Center students. Two students have logged on time. Hi, SouthX, Drishti, and Borivali students. Three students from Borivali. Yet we have more 50% of the students join who have not joined the session. I'm audible to everybody. Is my audio proper and clear? Okay. Vinod, can you please check the remote connectivity? Okay. So to begin with today's session, I want everybody to share with me that did you give your MT1 last week? Last Saturday, did you write the exam for Python? Please share in the hand raise, did you write the exam? So Mihir, Manish, Chaitra, Sonu, Ankur and Amay has given the exam. Others, can you all confirm? Why Annanagar Center, what happened? Why you didn't give the exam? So this feedback I will take from everybody. Let more number of students join the session. Okay, now see, today's session is very, very important one because today's session is very, very important because today I am going to discuss the project part with you. Now our first exam is over and we have to know about the project. Okay, fine, Abhirami I got, and Rohan has also written a reply. So this question I'll take from everybody. Let more number of students join. Fine, so today's session is very, very important because I'm going to talk about the project today. What exactly we are going to do in the project. And we have our next exam on 12th, okay? Our next exam is on 12th of August. So in between, we will have only one session, 5th. And then directly our exam will come. So what I have decided is, tomorrow we will have one extra session. I know tomorrow is Sunday, but please, I'm just requesting y'all to come only for one Sunday, so that you don't have to come on your exam day. On exam day, then there will be no class. Okay? So please support me, everybody. You will be there for the class tomorrow for Sunday. Only one Sunday, please. Same time, 1:30, 5:30 only. Maybe, like, if we are able to cover up the portion, I will leave you early. But 1:30 to 5:30, you take the time. Okay, so please everybody, I am requesting tomorrow just give your one Sunday for this course so that you are comfortable with everything and I also feel comfortable and we don't, do it hurried manner. So we will do it properly with the slow pace. Okay, so let's see what is that we are going to do for today's session. our today's session is about a topic that we are going to start, which is called as the regular expression. Oh no, dear, there's a problem. Because see, next week if I take, then you will not be able to complete your project. Why tomorrow I want to take extra session is because you should have time to do your project also. Okay, so if our more of the teaching part will be over, then we will have to work on the project part also. Okay, so let's start with today's class. What will be our today's topic? Today's topic is a topic which is called as Python regular expressions. Okay, we are going to cover a topic which is called as the Python regular expressions. Somebody wrote something in the hand raise. Can you slowly write? Don't remove it. I'm not able to read. Give me time to read your hand raise, please. Somebody who wrote something in the hand raise, can you again write that? So let's do a topic which is called as Python regular expressions. Now what is Python regular expressions? Many a times we create strings. String means some data of the character type. And these strings have some particular format. Like, you know, let's say a URL. Website URL is having a format. A URL will be considered as a valid URL only when it begins with www or http://. Okay? So a URL is, it should start with http://. Or let's say I'm accepting a telephone number or a mobile number from the user. Then I want my mobile number to be a 10-digit number. Or let's say I am taking a contact number which is containing area code and phone code, phone number. Then I want area code of 3-digit hyphen phone number or telephone number of some digits. Or it may be my requirement that I want all my student ID to belong, to start with letter S, and then I want the digits there. So what happens is, many a times when we write some data or we write some variable values, we want them to be of a particular format. Okay, so how we can get this format? We can get this format by using something called as the regular expressions. Okay, so what is regular expression? By the end of the module, you should be able to understand what is regular expression. Regular expression for complex searching. Why the regular expressions are used? They are used for performing complex searching on your data. Advanced regular expression techniques. So let's understand, what do you mean by regular expression? Specialized programming language embedded in Python. So this regular expression is a special part. It's something which is a very special part added into Python. Why? Because we have to format or we have to validate our data. Everyone understands, what do you mean by data validation? In data validation, we check that whether the input given by the user is correct or not, that data given by the user is proper or not. So now here we require something that if the user has given some data, whether it is correct or not. So that check we can do with the help of the regular expression. So specialized programming language embedded in Python, based on the rules definition and applying to a string. Always when you create the regular expression, remember, they will be applied to a data type called a string. You will never apply it to other data types. Like, you can't say that you will apply it onto a number data type. You will apply it on a string only. And in the string, you have the, you can have numbers. Okay? In string, we can have numbers and we can apply the formatting onto that numbers. So why it is useful? It is useful for doing the pattern matching. What is pattern? A pattern is a specific way of writing the program code or a specific way of writing some data. Like I gave you an example of student ID or your registration number that starts with R, or there is a telephone number, or there is a URL pattern. So all these strings, they have a particular pattern of writing. So we want to ensure that the data entered by the user is in the proper pattern or not. So this pattern matching we do with the help of this regular expression. So for simple pattern matching, better to use the find and search. So there are some more methods available in this called as find and search that we will see, also called as regex, and is universal to many languages. Regular expressions in short is also called as regex. Okay, regular expression in short is also called as regex. Now this regex is universal to many languages, meaning you will find regular expressions in different type of languages. Like Java also has regular expressions. Okay, ASP or .NET platform also has regular expression. Python has regular expression. So these regular expressions have some patterns which can be common to multiple languages. But the way you are going to write the code for them, they will be little different. So what is today's topic we are doing? Regular expression. So we'll just format our notes for the day. So what we are doing today is our session 8. So regular expressions, they are extremely useful in extracting information from text such as the code, log files, spreadsheets, or even the documents. And while there are a lot of theory behind the formal languages, the following lessons are example which we will use it for regular expression. I am just giving you their application. This you remove it, we don't require. And I am giving you what is regular expression. So it is something which is having all these features. Also called as regex in many universal languages. Okay. Now what are the steps that we have to do when we work with regular expressions? So regular expression steps. Submit a regular expression string. The first thing that we have to do when we work with our regular expression is creating a string. Okay. We have to create a normal string. Compile the string to get the regular expression bytecode. Apply the compiled bytecode. Obtain the search results and use the results. I will come to this step one by one. But you know, before we do something, I want to show you something simple part. And then we will go to a little advanced part. So just let me show you what is the use of regular expression. One example of regular expression we will do, and then we will check this. Okay, so what you have to do when you have to work with this regular expression. So let's open our Python prompt. Okay. So we've opened the students. Please don't come late for the class. There are two students who have joined just now. Please, I request everyone to come for the class on time. Don't be late for the class. So let's take a new program. Now why we do pattern application or regular expression? To do the pattern matching. Now for using regular expression, number one thing that you have to do is step number one. You have to import one library and that library name is RE. Step number one in your program. Import RE. What is RE? RE stands for regular expression. Okay. Now what you can do is next, you can say that what type of thing you want to do on your what is the type of the pattern you want to create? Okay, what is that you want to work? What is that you want to have in your pattern? So 1 minute, just take a simple bite for you. Please hold on. Okay. So let me come back to my program. Yeah. So step number one that you will do is you have to write a statement which is import RE. Okay. So what import RE will do? Will import the regular expression for you. Now the second thing that you need to do is you need to call the compile method. Step number two. Okay. Now step number two is call the compile method. How to call the compile method? This compile method is called with your RE library. So with this regular expression, you have a method called as compile. And what do we give in compile? The compile is something that is going to take your pattern here. Okay. So the syntax of this is, the syntax of writing the compile is RE.compile and the pattern. Now, you will learn what are the various types in which you can create the pattern. Okay, so about this pattern making we will learn shortly. So RE.compile and we have to give some pattern. Now this pattern we can't give just like anything. We have to give it in a proper way. So I'll just give you one pattern. So for example, I just want to check that if I am writing something, it should begin with S. Okay. So let's say I am saying that I want to create one student ID and it should begin with S. So for beginning with S, you have to use one character, which is this caret sign, and you will find it on letter 6 on your keyboard. See, there is number 6 on your keyboard. On that you will find this exponent sign. So here I am giving something like this. What does this mean? I am creating a pattern which says that whatever text I will give, that should begin with letter S. So once I have created a pattern, alright, so here I told that what kind of pattern I want. We can create this pattern in much more better way. I will be showing you that, so don't worry right now. Now once you have created and declared some pattern, what you have to do is you have to take this pattern in any object. Okay, you can give any name to that. So this RE.compile will return you a object which is nothing but a pattern. Okay, so what I'm doing is here, I am creating a object of a type pattern. I'm getting a object of type pattern. You can give the name to it as my pattern, or you can simply write pattern also. So step number two, call the compile method and you define your pattern, which will create a pattern for you. So what is basically this compile method will do is, see, here you are giving a simple string. Okay, so how my Python will understand that it has to be considered as a pattern? So compile method will convert that simple string into a pattern type and store it into this pattern variable. Okay, now once this pattern is saved, now we can use the pattern. Now on what we will use the pattern? We will use the pattern on some text. Okay, so what you can do is, maybe here I am creating one variable. Let's say student ID. Okay, student ID is my variable, and there I have given some student ID, something like this. This is my student ID. Okay, now what I am saying is, check that whether my student ID is matching to this pattern or not. Getting? I want to check that what I have given in the student ID is matching to this pattern or not. So now how do I check that? So here we have to call a method called as match. The match method of the pattern is used to check whether the pattern is matched or not. Okay, so whether this pattern is matched or not, that we will find with the help of a method called as the match method. So how do we call the next method, which is the match method? So this pattern object that we have created up will have a method called as the match method. Pattern dot match. Now on what you want to match the pattern? I want to match the pattern on SID. Where is the pattern? It is here in the pattern object. Check that what you have given in the SID, is it matching with this applied or defined pattern? So this on return type will return you a object of something which is a match type. You can take that in any object name. So pattern.match will return you one object. So that will contain the data whether it is matching or not. Now we have to check, is it matching or not? So what we will say, if match object. So that means if we have something in the match object, then what we want to do? Okay, so if it is there in the match object, then what I want to do is print, I'm just printing, print match found. I'm just printing like this, match found. Otherwise, I'll say else print match not found. Okay? So otherwise we will say that the match is not found. Alright? So this is the simple thing that we need to check. If my match is found, then what I want to do? Otherwise say match found. So let's have a look at this one more time. See students, again I am requesting you all, if you are writing something in the hand raise, please keep it. Let me read. Don't remove it. Okay, if you write something on top of that, what you are writing in the chat window will go away. So wait. Okay. Match. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dhruv. I had made a spelling mistake. So now, if match object is there, then say match found. Otherwise, match not found. Okay, so what we did here, in step number 1, we imported the regular expression. In step number 2, we call the compile method. In step number 2, we call the match method. Okay, so the match method of the pattern is used to check whether the match is found or not. And then here what are we doing in the next step? Print appropriate or print message whether match was found or not. Let's save our program. So let me save it into our folder. I'm giving a name to it as, say, regular expression 1.py. Okay, so regular expression 1.py is the name that I've given, and when I run it, I got a message, match found. Okay, I got a message, match found. Why here? Because I have written in my regular expression that check whether the given string is starting with letter S. Now suppose here I give R. Okay? Dhruv, I'll tell you. So suppose here in the beginning I give R and now I run my program. Now what I get? Match not found. Okay? So what is this? Is helping you to do is, this is your data and this is your pattern. Okay, this is your data and this is your pattern. Match method is helping you to check whether what data you have given is there according to the pattern. So if I give R there, I'll go to match not found, and if I write there S properly, I will get match found. Dhruv is asking me about the compile method again. Yeah, Dhruv, see, what is the use of this compile method? So what the compile method does is, the compile method converts a given string into a pattern. That is the job of the compile. You know what is compiling doing? It is converting into a proper pattern type. Otherwise it would be just understood as a simple text. So compile will convert it into a proper pattern, store it into one object. This is the data on which we want to perform the check. Below is the data on which check is required. Are you getting now what is the use of this regular expression? Everybody understood what is the use of regular expression? Please click on plus if it is understood, regular expression. Everybody confirm fast, please. Is the regular expression, this demo is understood? Starts with S. This sign meaning starting with. Like that, I'll tell you what are the various patterns. Here I've just given one simple pattern. So here, this symbol that we have given checks the beginning character, okay, or checks that the starts with. So whenever I want to check that my string is starting with some particular character or not, then you have to give that character sign followed by the character by which it can start. Okay, so this is one simple application of the regular expression. Now we will do a little more theory about it and then come to more details of creating the pattern. So this is a first simple example. So here let me write demo 1. Okay, now we'll do it in little detail. In if condition, why you have to compare the variable? Yeah, Gulam, why we have to do that is see in if condition. Now here if pattern dot match means if the matching pattern is found, the answer of that will be stored into one object called as the match object. So it's a boolean value. Or you can also do one thing, like here also you can write directly if pattern dot match. Here I'm taking it in another object. Now that is having a reason. Why is that? That you will understand after some time. So this is going to check a boolean value, true or false. So if the pattern is matching, then it will return true. If the pattern is not matching, it will return false. Okay, so that is the use of this match regular expression. Now let's go into little detail about everything now. So once you understood what is its application, we will again start over the theory part. Okay, let us understand the theory in more detail. Okay, so it's already 2 o'clock and I have the good number of students logged in now. So I want to ask you all. Okay, so if you have attempted Python exam 1, please say yes. And due to whatever reason you did not attend, you have to say no. Okay, so thank you so much everyone. Just wait, let me, you know, save this. All right, and did anybody get the marks? Why there is a need of match pattern? I already told you, Abhirami. Match is storing a boolean value. It is checking that is that pattern, matched pattern is found or not. Okay? Yeah, Sonu, can you tell me what is your score? Don't worry, I will not read out loudly. And everybody else who has got the score, can you please tell me? Okay, good. No problem, Sonu. You have to try better in your second exam and your project. Okay, no problem. Borivali Center. Oh, that's very, very cut off. Mihir, so when are you planning to give the improvement exam? Pamela, you also have to go for your supplementary exam. Study well and give the, now you know how was your exam. So Pamela, you have to plan properly, study and give your MT1. Who else? Oh, Dhruv. Dhruv, a little more study is required. So, Dhruv, when are you planning to give the next attempt? Twelfth is your MT2. Okay? Twelfth is your MT2. So, you have to see that you are studying for this. Anybody else who got the score? We have a supplementary exam, Mihir. So your center has to schedule a supplementary exam. One attempt is given to them. Okay? That I don't know, Dhruv. You have to please ask your center all that part. Okay? See, if you have scored 50 and above, you have cleared the exam. So, you have cleared the exam. You told you got 50, no? So, just you have cleared the exam. You don't have to give the supplementary. Okay. So, yeah, course not completed, I know, because still one more exam is there, no? Okay. So, fine. Anybody else who wants to share their exam score? Why somebody has logged in after half an hour? Who is that? Why you are coming at 2 o'clock? Why so late? I have already taken one program of regular expression. How you will understand if you are coming so late for the class, dear students? You have to see that you are coming on time. So let me quickly revise and we will go to the next part. So now you saw how it is specialized program. So specialized programming language for doing validation. And it is also called as regular expression. So now what we did, what are the steps in creating a regular expression program? Submit a regular expression string. So we created a string, that student ID string. Compile this string to get a regular expression bytecode. So what we did on that, we called the compile method. Apply the compiled regular expression bytecode to the target string. Apply the compiled regular expression bytecode. So now you have to apply that string. Means we have to do a pattern match. Obtain the results of the match and then use the results. So this is what we did in our program also. I told you import RE, compile, match. These are the methods you have to remember. So now let's look at some characters. What are the various characters we use? And then we will come to... Okay. Now for creating the regular expression patterns, please listen to this very very carefully everyone. Now to create different type of patterns, we have been given some meta characters. So that caret sign or exponent sign which I showed you in the previous example is nothing but it is called as a meta character. So Python is giving lot of meta characters like this to create a pattern. So what are the meanings of the various patterns? So let's see that dot. What is the meaning of dot? Dot matches any one character except the enter key or slash in. So wherever I have to represent only one single character, I have to give a dot. Okay. So let's say I have to check the second character in my string, then I can give dot dot. If I have to check the very first character, dot. Like that. So dot is something which matches any one character. Slash W matches any alphanumeric character. Alphanumeric meaning it can be anything. It can be a letter, it can be a number or something. Slash W any non-alphanumeric character means special characters. Hash, dollar, all that. Slash D is for matching of any digit. Whenever you have to check the numbers, you can go for slash D. Whereas capital slash D is for any non-digit. Small s for any white space character. And the capital slashes matches any non-white space character. What do you mean by white space character? Spaces, tabs, enter key, all that characters which are not visible on the screen when you type. If you give a space, will it print something on the output? No. Or if you give a tab, they are non-visible characters. So those non-visible characters are called as white space characters. So if you want to check whether there is a space or something, then you can use slashes. capital S for any other character apart from that white space. Now, these square brackets are used to match any one character from the given set. You will have to, by heart all this. So there is, this thing is something which is important. So the list of the meta characters in regular expression. Because of this all meta characters, we will be able to create a pattern. So, square brackets matches any one character. Like here, if I write in square bracket A and T, means that either it can be A or it can be T. If I write A to G, meaning matches any character between A to G, inclusive, A will also be considered, G will also be considered. Not A to or something that is this one, exponent, means any character except from this set. Okay? So, not of AT can also be given, meaning it is used to also do the negation. Negation meaning don't consider any value or character between A to T. Brackets are used for grouping purpose. A pipe sign is used for giving more than one condition, or it is OR condition. And the slash is used for negating a meaning of a character. Negating a meaning of character means what? Suppose I want to check for a dot only. So dot is specially a meta character. So what we will do, whenever I want to do a dot checking, I can write a more slash before that. So what this slash will do is, it will remove the special meaning of this dot. So slash is used for negating the meaning of the meta character. Are you getting? See, if I want to check a slash only, and slash itself is a meta character, then it will not create a proper pattern. So what we will do, before that we will give a slash. Or I want to check this character. Okay. Or I want to check a dollar. Dollar is also a meta character. So before that we will give a slash, so that the special meaning of that meta character is removed. So here, we will talk about more meta characters. So these are some more meta characters I told you, and then this thing, this chart. Okay. So this caret sign is something which is match in the beginning of the string. Now this caret sign is used in two ways. You can use it to match in the beginning of the string, and also if you use inside the square brackets, then it is for negating, means not. So that will represent a not. Okay? Yeah, yeah. I'm just telling you that, Dhruv, there are two uses of that. So this character is used for the beginning also. If you use it inside that square brackets, not of AT, then it is don't consider the characters between A and T. But if you would have written Dhruv only caret sign and AT, means check that it is beginning with A, like that. Dollar matches the end of the string. Star, zero or more occurrences of the previous character. Plus, zero or more occurrences of the previous character. So if I want that I should be able to check more than one match, then it is. Okay, so zero or more than one, it can occur or it may not occur. But here, one or more means at least one time that character should be existing. Here, it may not exist or it can exist. Question mark. Zero or more occurrences of the previous character. So most of the time you will find that this star and question mark are same only. Either you can use a question mark character or you can also use a star character. Curly braces, M, N, minimum M occurrences and maximum N occurrences. So where you have to give your limitation, that let's say the digit should be 10 times at least, and then it can be 15 times, between 10 to 15, then you can use the square brackets. Okay, so let's do more meta characters examples now. So suppose I say slash A to Z dot dot. Okay, so this would match the following. Slash D. Slash D is for what? Digit. Okay, so in that chart we saw, we had slash D for digit. So what is that we have written here? Slash D, and in square brackets A to Z. Okay, so what does this mean? That here my pattern will begin with a number, then contain any character, and then I can have any other two digits. It can be a digit or any other two characters. So anything would be allowed. Two numbers would be allowed there, or two digits will be allowed there, or another two numbers. But what I want is, in the start there will be a number, and then followed by that I want one character only, and then two other characters can be there. I'll explain you this. So let's put it in this. Now every time that program structure will remain same only the pattern will change now. So what we will do in the pattern, we are saying I want to create a pattern that will have one digit in the beginning. My second letter can be anything between capital A to Z. Okay. Followed by that I can have any two characters. Okay. Followed by that I can have any two characters. So that means here if I put something like this R, or let's say I put something 9R00. This will be valid. And then let me do a pattern match with that. What we got? Match not found. We wrote a underscore there. I want capital A to Z. Okay, see, match found. Look at this. Why it is giving us match found? This is our output, see. So, first is the digit. Second is any character between A to Z, and then I can have any other characters. They can be numbers or they can be anything. Okay? So let's say I am creating more other patterns. Now what you do is, when you are doing the practice, I am creating multiple variables and you just have to supply it here by changing them. So now I am not going to give a digit. Okay? And I am giving all other numbers like this. Here, let's say, again, I am giving a digit. I am giving a this. And after that, I am giving any two characters. And then here, I am giving a digit and a number. Then I am giving any other two characters. Okay? So, let's see that now. I am going to... See, SID1 will give me correct output that we tested. Let's check for SID2 now. So SID2 is returning us what? Match not found. See, I got here match not found. So why SID2 is not match not found? Tell me. Write in the hand raise everyone. Tell me why we got match not found. Quickly, according to the pattern, what we require? First, we require a digit. But have we given a digit? No. What we gave in the beginning? We gave a character. Understood? We gave a character. I want somebody to repeat quickly. Sahil Kumar from CP Center. Hello? Hello, Sahil, are you there? I'm getting echo from Sahil Kumar. I'll again try to connect you to Sahil. Can you adjust the cam, please? No, still the same problem, Sahil. Not able to connect you. Varun Arora? Hi, Varun.
Hello.
Yeah. So tell me, why is that that second is giving match not found?
Ma'am, because it is starting with a character not a number.
Okay. And tell me, will SID 3 will be correct or wrong?
Ma'am, it's correct.
Correct. Okay. Thanks. Now, we have taken one more case where we have given at the rates. So let us check for SID 4. So, match found. Because any other characters it will allow. So, it may not be those A to Z or anything, but at the rate is also okay. We can use that. Okay, can we match all at a time? No, we will have to put lot of if conditions, Dhruv. If I have to put all that, then I have to write multiple if conditions there. Okay, so that's why I'm just doing one by one. So I hope now everybody understood what is a pattern, how it is happening. Now, let's do one more example. So problem solving with regular expression. Now what you want to do is write a function that would validate an enrollment number. What you want to do that is enrollment number is something like this. We want enrollment number to be starting with letter U. Okay. It should start with letter U. Then it should have numbers. Okay, so example of enrollment number is given to you. So it is starting with U, then there are some digits available there, right? Then there is F, C, S are some other characters, and then 498. So 13 is the year of registration that can be between 00 to 99. Here 13 is the registration, year of registration, which can be between 00 to 99. And CS, EC or BT can be the last three digits. So here when we give this thing, here I can have either CS or BT or EC. So how are we going to create a pattern for that? Okay. Now what we want here is see U starting, U. And then after that we want to have four digits in it, right? There are four digits. Then again two digits are there, but that is having one condition. Then the letter F. Then there is a collection. So let's try to do this. Okay. So I'm not writing step and all. Now you know that. So program to check a enrollment number. Okay, so what we want to do? We want to do an enrollment number check. So the first thing that you will do is import RE. Pattern we have to create now here. So now try to think what will be the pattern. What is the first part saying? It should start with U. So tell me, what do I write if I want that it should start with U? I showed you in the first example, remember? What do I do if I want to check that it should start with letter U? For starting with which character I told you? Very good. Very good. Keep it up. Sonu, you are writing any letter between A to Z. I want only letter U. And that too capital. Starting with letter U. So for starts with what symbol I told you? Which meta character is used for beginning with check? Very first example I told you, remember? Starting with S, your student ID should begin with letter S. Then what character I used there? Fast, it's easy. Which character I told you there to match beginning with? Forgot? this one, caret sign, and then letter U. Okay? Starts with U. No, see, if we give starts with W, Ghulam Ali, then I am not checking all the characters. I want only one specific character. If I write W, then it will allow any valid character. So, we don't want any alphanumeric character. We want only U. Okay, now after that, what we want? We want four digits. So, what is that we used for the digit in the previous one I told you? Which meta character is used to match the digit? Yes, Sonu, correct? Which meta character we used for matching the digit? Yes, so the meta character that we used was D, slash D. Now I have to do like this for how many numbers? Four. So what I will do is I will write this four times. Slash D, slash D, slash D. But they should be in one group. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them into one round bracket like this so that they will create a group. Now after that we require one more number. 13, this is the number that is given, 13. But on that there is one validation. This number that we will give after the four digits has to be between 0 to 99. That number that we give should be between a particular range. It should be between 0 to 99. So tell me which meta characters we used for the range check. Like A to Z. Okay? A hyphen Z. That we kept in what symbol? Very good, Rishabh. Good, good. So, A to Z we placed in what? Where I can create a range check. Whenever you want to do a range check, you will use square brackets. Now, in square brackets, what we want to check? We can check A to Z and we can also check for numbers 0 to 99. Done this much? Then what we have to do? We want letter F after that and it should be compulsorily letter F only. So we will give letter F. But after letter F now, the next other two characters can be CS, EC or BT. So tell me, which meta character is used for OR symbol? Which meta character is used for OR symbol? I showed you here. Look at this chart. Which symbol is used for OR condition? I'm showing you the chart. Wait, it's coming on your screen. Little projection delay is there. So that's why I'm waiting for your screen to get updated. See now. See that chart I have shown you? Which symbol is used for OR condition? Good. So here what we will do? We have to use a OR. Now what do we do for that? For the OR, for OR pattern now, for the OR pattern, we can use that pipe sign. So this pipe sign, I will use in one group because I have groups, no? So it can be CS or it can be EC or it can be BT. Done. Again, after those numbers we have given, then again what we want, see here. Again, we should have how many digits? 4, 9, 8. Again, we should have 3 digits. So tell me, what do I write here to match those 3 digits? Again, I should have 3 digits now. Only one time D I will give. We here got it correct. So the next group I can say slash D slash D slash D. Done. Okay. So like that we have created our pattern. This way we have created our pattern. Read this carefully and tell me if you have not understood, and we will also try to check it now. So here we will put our data, enrollment number. So I am creating one variable, enrollment number, and let me give one enrollment number, let's say the one which is given here only. But the only thing, we don't want any hyphens and all into that. So just in order to show you these groups, the things have been given with a hyphen. We don't want a hyphen there. So this is our group match. Now match object pattern dot match with what I have to match? En roll number. Okay. So if match object, then say match found. Otherwise not found. Oh, we got match not found. So what has happened? We got match not found. I hope there is no space or anything we have given. There are few more functions we are going to discuss. Just let me have a look at this, about this pattern, then we will go ahead. So starting with letter U, then we have four digits. See the, I think this slash D we had missed. We wanted this 0 to 99 digit, okay? So one more slash D there, then F, then CSET, and then slash DDD three times, okay? So now when I am giving a match here, you can give it in a variable, or you want, you can give it directly into here also. So here I have given it directly, or you can do it like this also, enrollment number. So this enrollment number, let me put in one variable, and then here I can check this my variable. Okay, so like this I am checking my variable match found, otherwise match not found. So now we are getting the output match found. Okay, see, just now you don't look at the commented part. Yeah, we did that, Kedar. Yes. Now see, don't look at that commented part, this two print lines you forget. You just try to look at the pattern and you understand the output. So tell me, is this clear to all, everyone? Anybody who did not understand this pattern? In exam, you can have such a type of question. So please understand this very well. And now you know how the MT was. So you should be very well prepared now that you are taking all this seriously so that you score good marks in your second exam now. Can you explain why we haven't used starting? No, see, we have not used the caret F. Why? Because it is not in the beginning, no? F is there in between the string. So if it is in the between, we don't need to give anything there. Okay? We don't need to give anything. Alright? So this way, we have created this. I'm still waiting for you all, everyone. Please use the poll if you have understood this. How we created this pattern. This is for starting with 4 digits in one group, then one more digit, but it should be in the range between 0 to 99, and then a letter F, then it can be CS, ES, EC or BT, and then there can be 3 more digits. Please raise your hand if you have not understood. I am again and again asking you. Or otherwise you have to confirm that you have understood. Is that understood or not? Pamela from Alipur Center. Hello. Pamela, your audio video is not coming. Please get it checked by your technical person at the center. Rishabh, Dariahat. Hi, Rishabh.
No.
Yeah, Rishabh, can you please explain back this pattern?
I'm not sure. So first it's checking, the first letter is U. Then we're checking if, you know, all the four digits are available, there or not. So we're using slash D four times. Then after that, we need to check if the input is from 0 to 99. And since it's a number, that is the reason we're using slash D and then 0 to 99.
Mm.
So the next character should be F.
Mm.
So we have written F. And after that, it's CS, EC or BC. Either one of them has to be there.
Mm.
So we have used the odd character.
Mm.
And then again for 3 digits.
Exactly.
And slightly.
Correct. Yeah. Thanks, Rishabh. So I hope that everybody has understood this pattern making program. Okay. Now let's try to study this something with the dot dot. Read this pattern. Now what this pattern is saying, AA dot dot T dot 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 A means that the pattern should have AA followed by any two characters, then followed by T, then again followed by any two characters and then followed by A. Actually we should give only two dots, okay? So there is one extra dot. Okay, so it is something like this. Read this. Try to read this slowly and check. Read this slide, everyone. Dot dot means one single character. So I want that it should be beginning or starting should be AA. Then I can have any other two characters. They can be XX, ZZ, anything. After that I want it to be T. Then again any two characters and then I want it to be A. So those gaps that we are leaving in between to fit in one character, that is by a dot. Yeah, exactly. You can have any characters there. They can be any special characters also, Sonu. Correct. But it should be at the end there will be A. T, then you have given an exponent or at the rate, and after that also we will have one letter A. Okay, Sonu? Now, slash D matches any digit. So what does this mean? Means that the pattern should have A followed by two digits and then followed by the X. So now you have understood this. Capital D matches any non-digit. So A dot dot, then it can be any other non-digit, meaning any other numbers there, and then it should have X letter. Okay? So these all other examples are given to you for understanding. Meta characters, see this. ATTAGCCA. Now, this that you write, you can write it like something that is beginning with letter A. Then I have a digit. So if I don't want to write slash D, we can also write like this, range 0 to 9. So writing A slash D X X is also equal to A 0 to 9. Okay? Or writing like this, A not of 0 to 9 is same as A capital D slash capital D X X. Or we are writing A slash W X X. It is same as writing A slash W means any character. So it can be a character between small a to z, capital A to Z, or it can be a digit. So for that, this W is used. So W also contains a 0 to 9 character. So any alphanumeric character, meaning it is combining of numbers also and the characters also, but no special characters. We are not allowing no special characters in that. So whenever you have a range of slash W, it means this one. Okay? So I want to allow these all ending with. So I told you about this, all other meta characters usage. Okay? Is this last one clear to you? First two are easy only, but last one you understood? Let me know. Which I have highlighted there. Slash W for capital A to Z, small a to Z, and 0 to 9. So if you want to allow any characters in between those range, you can do that. And square brackets are always used to show a range. Quickly, please confirm everybody. Is that understood? This already we did one example of meta character. Okay, now coming to meta character in little more detail. Now, what we have to do is we have a function which is last part. Okay, you did not understand last part. See, here what does this mean? It can be starting with letter A, and then here I can have any character which can be small letter A to Z, then XX, like this. Or it can be A, it can be a number, and then XX. Or it can be A, capital letter, and then XX. Like that the meaning is. Understood? Examples for last. Somebody who had asked me that last part not understood. See, these are the valid examples. G, 9, or capital W. So this position can be replaced by any other valid character. Understood? Only OR condition is not used. See, why we will use OR there when we have to give either of this, like that. So OR we are not providing in this. If you want to combine this with OR, you can do that. See, once you know all the meta characters, now creating a pattern is in your hand. Okay? How to create the pattern is now in your hand. you can mix and match and create your patterns. Now let's look at one function which is called as the group function. Now I showed you in the this one, okay, I showed you here, but I had commented something, right? So let's see what is the meaning of that comment. I'm just going to remove this comment here. Print match object dot group. So there is one function called as the group. Okay, so with the match object you have one function which is the group function. So here this match object is not only serving you as a boolean data, but it is also having some inbuilt functions. So the match object dot group will display for you the first group that is matched, okay? And also let me show you this one. First we will just check for the group, what happens with the group. Now see what is this is doing. When I say match object dot group, it will give me the full string, okay? Match object dot group will give me full string. But if you want to be specific about the groups you want to extract, okay, so if you want to be specific about the groups you want to extract, one minute, there are more group related functions. See, so this match object has the following methods. Group will return the matching substring. Start will return the starting position of the match. End will return the position where the match is ended. And span will return the tuple of start and end position. So this group I showed you, which is giving us full text, okay, so here you can also whatever this return object is, with that you use m dot group. And there is, you can also use something like this, match dot group of 0 gives the entire pattern found. Match dot group of 1 gives the first group. Match dot group of default equal to none returns all the group as list. Now here in the example, when we wrote match group match object dot group, what it will do, it will display the displays the entire matching string. So what was that match that was found? So it gave me the full matching string. Now if I just want to get the first matching group, then you can say match group of 1. So display the first matching group. If you don't give anything, it is as good as giving as 0. Or nothing. So displays the first matching group. So let's see. Now see which is the first matching group it is giving you. My first matching group is a group of 4 digits. 1011. Where are the brackets written? Brackets are written to create a group. So in our pattern where we have written the brackets, this is my first group. Try to understand this. If I have done something like this, here how we have created the groups? The groups are nothing but the one that are written in the bracket. So this is my group 1. Okay, so if group 1 I do, I fetch this thing. Getting? If I go for another group, so where we have written one more set of brackets, this one. Okay, so that is my another group. Are you getting? Let's try to see now what do we get with that group 2. We will say, so if you don't want to get the full string and you just want to retrieve the groups out of your data, that you can do. So what is my next group? See, I got EC as my next group. So, and this is my third group, third set of round brackets. So my third set of round brackets, if I want to obtain, I will say print group of 3. So displays here, it will display the second matching group. Here it will display the third matching group. Got it? Now, if you want to also print that where are the groups starting and ending positions, their index positions, then you can give match object dot start, match object dot end. So where is my group position, like where is my match object matching is starting and ending, otherwise say not found. So what do we get? The entire string was found to be matched where starting position is 0 and ending position is 13. Understood? So this is the use of the group function. Start and end will simply give you the indexes. So here we got 0 and here we got 13. So this is the 0th position and this is the last 8 is the 13th position. 8th number. 0, 1, 2, 3. What we got in the output? We got 13. Yeah, correct only, 13 only. Okay? 13 is the last position. It will return the last position number starting with index value 0. Like, you know, as if we do it in the slicing and all, Sonu, that's how. Okay? So these are the uses of this function. You don't have to go for additional other functions. Okay, let's do this one. What is the use of a method called as find all for writing only U? Yeah, Dhruv, U is the 0, no? It is showing you what is the starting index value. So for that start, we have the start method and for end, we have the end method. So for that U, it was showing like that U is at the 0th position. U we can't show because it is not in the group. Group function will show you only the groups, right? Okay, now let's do one more. I am creating another regular expression, regular expression dot compile. And we have created a regular expression containing slashes, www slashes. So regular expression dot find all. So regular expression dot find all. And we have given a string there. A cat ran after and some number and dogs. So for every M in M list, okay, find all the matching occurrences and print it for me. So what it is printing? Cat and 432. Cat and 432 it has printed. Meaning, see, slash s is for string words. And small w, you know that it is also for numbers. Right? So it has given me the first occurrence. First occurrence of the word. And first occurrence of the digit. first occurrence of the word and first occurrence of the digit is shown to you. So where there is a group of characters. Here M is the just one variable. Okay. Here M is simply one variable which will help you to extract that from collection, M list. So find all is helping you to find some patterns based on this compilation that checks something that is having such a kind of pattern. It is a string or containing any alphanumeric characters. It should be small string containing any alphanumeric characters. So if you look at that small s, you know, where we had written the small s, look at that chart. Small s matches any white space character. Okay. So match any white space character and then print in it. Okay. So what, why we are getting cat and why we are not getting A in the output is because we want that it should be starting with a space and then any characters. Okay. And then again ending with a space. So cat is the word which is having space before it and space after it. Okay. So that's why it has given you cat in the output. So this is what the find all can do for you. And rest other functions I have already told. Okay, let's try doing this one also. Span. What is the use of span? Since we have done all this, so print match object dot span. Okay. So match object dot span, if we give, what do we get? We will just get the same output, but just in bracket we are getting 0 to 13. Okay. Just 0 to 13 we are getting. Yeah. See, what find all is doing is, Amay, in find all we said we want to have some word which is applying this pattern starting with a white space. Starting with a white space, meaning we should have one space before that word. Then it can be www. W is for what? It can be any small letter s, small letter a to z, capital letter a to z, or it can be a number. So www. C is W, A is W, T is W. Right? And then after that we want a space. So that's why we got a cat. Okay, now we are getting only the first occurrence of that, and also here if you notice we got 432 also, because here it is a number type in which there is spaces in the beginning and in the end. Okay, we got a space between beginning and end, that's why. So this one which is returning you in the answer, it showed you cat and 432. Okay. So there should be three words in that. Okay. So that is the meaning of if you want, I'll just write here the meaning of this. Starting with space. Then three characters. Again a space. So that's why we are getting those characters in the output into one collection, and then we are reading them one by one. So that is all we have done with the regular expression. Now, RAN is not coming because it is just giving you the first matching types only. actually RAN should have been included, but it is checking for first one matching type and then another matching type. After and dogs is out of scope, I know that, but RAN is something which is not included. Why? Because this space has been already included in the cat. Okay, so while it is reading, this one is not getting a space. Okay, that's why that is not getting included. It has already included this space with this cat pattern. So for this, this RAN is not getting a pattern. So with that, we have done regular expressions. Now based on the regular expression, you have some lab exercises to be done. Okay. Dhruv, small letter slash s means it should match a white space. It can be a space on the keyboard, space bar. Okay, that is small s. Or it could be a tab also, tab or a space. So slash s is for space, you can say. Now, will you be able to do this question? See, input a URL from the keyboard and validate whether if the URL is starting with http://, or https://. Very easy pattern. Can you all try that quickly? Input a URL from the keyboard and validate it by checking URL starts with HTTP or http://. So what you will give inside the compile function? Try to guess that and write the pattern in the hand raise. http://, or https://. Meantime, I'll just take this example for you in our notes. Let me see. Okay, Rishabh has written, but Rishabh, we want that it can start with https://. Also, so tell me which character we use for starting with. You should apply something for starting with, correct? Starting with this set, or it could be starting with another set. And one more thing, we have to say /. Also, we have to check for those /s also. Rishabh, yes, you are near to the answer. Starting with, so exponent caret http://, or, so what we will give for or now, tell me which symbol we use for or. Try to put that or symbol now. Yes, or is that pipe sign. So try to put everything together now. You'll get it. It's easy. Yes, good. Good attempt. So, all those students who have made a good attempt. So, import RE starting with http://, or http://. Okay, so we have given this as one group, input the URL, and here we will check, is it matching? If it is matching, then display it as a valid URL. So input a URL. Let's input a URL. So https://, let's say valid URL. See, I got in the output valid URL. Again, let me show you with the invalid URL. I'm giving a URL invalid URL. Easy? So this is one easy exercise that we completed of our lab. So check whether, I'll give you the lab question. We did input a URL from the user in keyboard and check whether it is starting with the proper letter or not. Okay, so now we will cover one more lab question, and after the break I'm going to discuss the project. Very, very important part we will do for the project, because we are just coming to the end of our regular expression topic, and after regular expression we will be doing SQLite today. Very interesting topic we will do, SQLite databases. Then we have to have one more lesson for tomorrow. Okay. All right. So we'll take a break now. Everyone, we'll take a break and be back at 3:25. You can take a break of 15 minutes.